Hey, what's up, guys? Nicole Purvey, the founder of the Better Than Success Real Estate League and real estate investor here. And today we are going to talk about doorknobs. I know it sounds really, really boring, but trust me, you will appreciate this. We're going to talk about doorknobs and interior door types. And so I have a story for you that's kind of entertaining. One of our members posted on Instagram the other day, one of the members from the Better Than Success Real Estate League, she posted on Instagram the other day that she was walking through a property and it was a rehabbed property. And she's like, this is the craziest thing. The doorknobs on the closets lock on the inside and the outside. And she's like, what? This is so just bad. And so my response to her was, yes, it is bad. But as an investor, this is not something that I would do. But when you start getting down to the finish line in your project, especially if you've gone over budget, and I can imagine right now, anybody that finished a rehab within the last couple of months, that means that they could have potentially started it before COVID. And since COVID happened, the price of labor and materials went through the roof, like through the roof. So you could be going through a project. This really affects you if you have a hard money loan. You could be going through a project and right in the middle of the project, all of your costs just going up like crazy. I know, it's been a nightmare. And if that's you and you're over budget, when you start getting down to the wire and buying hardware and doorknobs and stuff like that, you're like at your wit's end. You're like, I'm already over budget. What do we have in inventory? What's on the sale rack? I don't care. That's not me. I've been there mentally, but that's not me. But I can see someone saying that, like, hey, remember that project that we did a year ago? Do we got any doorknobs left over from that project? I don't care. It's the wrong kind. Throw it on there. So that's what I said in the comments. And then her response was, listen, that makes logical sense, but this project is just shoddy work. And so I wouldn't be surprised if they just really didn't know what they're doing. So it could be either or. I have no idea. But I was just trying to give them the benefit of the doubt. Maybe they were just like, let's just get this work done. But either way, whether you're over budget or not, I don't want you to use the wrong type of doorknob for your project, because this is a $10, $100 problem that could potentially cost you thousands of dollars, especially if you're doing a flip. Little details like that could limit how much you get when you go to sell the property. Like little details. Remember, the devil's in the details. So little details like that could cost you thousands of dollars. So we want to make sure that we choose wisely when we do think about how we can save in our budget. But you need to know, if it's a question about doorknobs, you need to know what type of doorknobs and especially what type of interior doors. So you guys know that I invest remotely. I'm in California and all of my projects are in Philadelphia. So I work with my project manager and I'm doing anything that I can do remotely to keep him moving fast, I do. So I'm buying everything on Home Depot, Lowe's. We have a couple of local vendors in Philadelphia. I'm calling them up. They have my account. My VA is doing what she can. So I am very, very, very aware of the cost and the types of these little teeny tiny things. To be quite honest with you, when before COVID, before I had my baby, before I moved to California, I have no idea why I went into any store. I used to be running around at Home Depot like a chicken with my head cut off. Why? I don't know. We were stupid. But thank God for just the internet. So, okay, let's just hop right into this conversation about doorknobs. Okay, so we got four different types of doorknobs that I want you to know about as you are doing your rehab. The first type of doorknob is the dummy doorknob. The dummy doorknob doesn't turn, doesn't lock, it does nothing. It's just there, a place for you to be able to pull and open the door. You're going to use these on passage doors, a door that connects two rooms that you want to be able to go freely through, pantries, small closets, things like that. So just keep in mind that this dummy doorknob is to be used for something that you know you're not going to be turning, you're not going to be locking. The next type of doorknob is called a passage doorknob. A passage doorknob is, you can use this for a passageway, you can use this for a pantryway as well. You can use this for a closet, right? Perfect. It doesn't lock, this is usually the type of doorknob you're going to use for a closet. The next type of doorknob is a privacy doorknob. A privacy doorknob locks on one side. So think a bedroom, think a bathroom, where you just go into the bathroom and then you're locking on one side. You don't want to, what's the point? Why would you lock? I mean, I don't know, maybe you got some crazy kids, or I don't know, a really intelligent dog that knows how to turn doorknobs. But this locks on one side. And then the last one is a keyed entry doorknob. This is typically your front door where it has a lock or some mechanism to lock on one side as well as the other side. So sometimes you'll see a key on the outside and then like a little twisty thing on the inside, or sometimes you see a key on both sides. But those are the four types of doorknobs. So if you are a control freak like me and you like to have control over your projects and you're not the GC, but you wanna know what's going on and you're actually buying materials, when you could get down to your doorknobs, go through and count all these types of doors and mark off, okay, I want a dummy doorknob here, a passage doorknob here, a keyed entry, a privacy here. And so you're not in a situation where you could potentially be buying doorknobs for closets that lock on the inside. Like, that's really weird, right? Okay, the next thing you're going to be thinking about is your interior doors. We are not going to talk about exterior doors today. The first type of door is a slab door. You guys have seen this millions of times. Slab doors usually have panels on it. There are usually for closets. They could be for entryways, usually have panels on it. The next type of door is the bifold door. The bifold door is usually for a closet. So it's almost accordion type. It's two panels. And so they go like this. And then when you open it, they go like that. And then the other side goes like that. You know exactly what I'm talking about. It depends on the space, but they save space, right? So if you've got a small space, and they're relatively inexpensive. So if you've got a small room that needs a closet, these bifold doors are great because they're not taking up so much space when you open a door, and they look really good to tenants or potential buyers to make the space feel more spacious. Just think about it, right? I don't know why, but it's a psychological thing. The next type is very, very popular are these barn doors. Barn doors usually have a sliding element and it's got wheels. I have never put a barn door in any of my properties. If I was like looking at a dream home for myself and there's a barn door there, I'm not like gonna be like, oh, get rid of the barn door. It's just not, it doesn't move me all that much. And the last interior door type I wanna talk about is French doors. You've seen these. They open up, right? So it's usually two doors that open up and they have glass panels. So it's a great way to add this really French element to the home, let a lot of light in. Yes, if you open them, they're gonna let a lot of air in as well. And these are your options. French doors are a little bit more expensive. So if you're doing low income rentals like me, you're gonna be slab door and bifolding it away. slab, bifold. The other thing I do wanna say this to you about slab doors is my project manager is really, really particular about this. I don't care about the number of panels that are on the slabs, on the slab doors. I don't care. You can have two panels, you can have four panels, you can have six panels. And he's like, I don't remember which one he likes the most. I think he likes the four panel. I don't care. But you know, some people are more passionate about interior decor and design than others. Me, is it going to get a tenant in? Is it going to get a quality tenant in? Let me know which one to choose. I don't think a quality tenant is going to be like, there's only six panels on that door. I don't want to move in there. I don't care. What do they have? What do they have in terms of quantity that keeps the space uniform? Do we have a need for eight? Do they have eight? Oh, they only have six of the four? No, we're not going to go with that. Let's keep it uniform and keep it pumping. Save this video as you are doing your next rehab so that you can be up on it when your GC is talking to you about these doors and the doorknobs and the cost of them and all that good stuff. All right, guys, I love you all. Have an amazing day and happy entrepreneur. Oh, wait. really quickly before you go, if you are new to real estate, I have a free course that gives you the 101 about real estate, how to find a good deal, what's the best way for you to start investing in real estate based on the resources that you have, how to tell the deal is a good deal or a bad deal, some real estate math. Just get my free course. It's free. It's free for you. Go to betterthansuccess.com, betterthansuccess.com/free course. And you can get my free course instantly. It's only like an hour and some change, and it'll change your life. All right, guys. I love you all. Have a great day. This is Goodbye For Real. And until next time, happy entrepreneuring.